anything about whomever this person is. And I'm not saying it's Mike Pence, maybe, but I don't know who this person is. So this person, maybe, this is one way of reading the clarification card, maybe is like gay or something, or covertedly, like hiddenly gay, because of the rainbow. This is the only reason that I'm saying this, because of the rainbow. However, what I get from this card, it's not exactly the rainbow. It's the creepy smile on this person's face. This is why I say this card is creepy to me, because it's beautiful colors, and there's the rainbow and all of that. But what I keep seeing is this guy with the creepy face and his eyes, like, I don't know. it's like, so I'm not necessarily thinking gay, or like gay hiddenly, being gay in a hidden way, this person, whomever this person is, whomever the next president is. I'm thinking like, I don't want to say that he's a creepy guy, but there might be something in his eyes. There might be something in his eyes that's a bit creepy. So maybe what makes him creepy is conservative values. And I'm getting, again, holding the light, because this figure is playing with the rainbow. So he's playing with the rainbow, making me think that he truly believes that he holds some sort of light in terms of conservative religious values. That's one way of reading it. Another way of reading this card is maybe this person played quote unquote with gay rights, played in a negative way, meaning played around quote unquote with gay rights, meaning just manipulated certain things in order to not allow gay rights to be upheld, and in order to only allow conservative rights to be upheld. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is why, this is a creepy card to me. I don't know, it kind of looks gay in the old sense, like happy. But every time I look at this person's face, I'm like, no, this is a creepy person. This is a creepy person who might seem really happy on the outside, but this person kind of manipulates things in a certain way to get his own conservative values upheld. And it might seem all glitter and light to the others. It might seem rainbow and puppies and kittens and all of that, but he's like doing stuff in a way that makes them sure that conservative values are the ones who are followed. So it seems one thing, but he's like a person who's a very controlling person. He might not seem like a very controlling person, but he is a very controlling person. And in the past, many things had to be done in order for him, whomever this person is, be president. So many things had to be manipulated. You know, another thing that I'm getting from this clarification card is like magic. It's like using the law of attraction to make them sure that he would be president. Or even some sort of secret rituals to make them sure that he would be president there. I got so many things from these two cards. Anyway, what's in his mind, or that which he wants? And it's cold in Portugal. It's really cold in Portugal. Ooh, it's white tea that I'm drinking. I'm gonna read, yeah. This could also be the way he is. No. that which the population of the US would want. But I'm reading more this as that which he wants or what's in his mind. It could be two different things. Now, it's the Queen of Swords. The Queen of Swords might represent a person, could be a man or a woman, in of an air sign, in her or his late 30s, after or after the age of 40, from Gemini, Aquarius or Libra. Gemini, Aquarius or Libra. You know what I'm thinking? Saturn will be entering Aquarius in a while, in the 2.5 years. What if this person, what he wanted is to be president within the next 3 years, which kind of fits the timeline, right? So, again, a conservative person, a religious person, someone who had a boyhood dream of becoming president, someone who has the backing of the family, someone whose family might have been in politics for a very long time, someone who worked a lot in order to become president, someone who will have to work a lot after becoming president, and his health might take a hit because of that. What if this person is already working into becoming president within the next 3 years when Saturn enters Aquarius? That's what I'm thinking. Maybe it will be while Saturn is in Capricorn, but maybe he will become president when Saturn enters Aquarius. In 3 years. 2021? Which, right, in 2020 there's another election. So in 2021, he would be sworn in as a president. Maybe that's it's in his mind. And this is the clarification card. And what is this? This is, again, the feeling that I'm having is a spiritual card. It's more spiritual than religious. The Sword of Justice, in order to bring spirituality back to the US, one way of reading it. So maybe this is what he wants. Maybe within the next 3 years, he wants to be sworn in as the next president. And he wants to be seen in a very humble sort of way. So he will be humbled in his role as a president. So he wants to be also a very smart and intelligent person, a person or president. He wants to do his role in a way that seems humble, but at the same time intelligent and very competent, like the opposite of Donald Trump. He wants to be seen as someone who's extremely intelligent, but at the same time humble. That's what's in his mind. You have to be intelligent and you have to be humble. So in order to become president, this person, it's like I'm reading more about this person now, the way he is thinking, the way he's doing, what is his strategy in order to become president? What is his strategy in order to become the next president? His strategy is to become really smart, is to appear to everyone really smart and at the same time humble. It's the opposite of Donald Trump. Yeah, he's smart, this dude. Conservative and he's smart. And it's like a three-year plan, I would say. Maybe in 2021, there'll be like a new president. But again, I don't know, okay? So, the near future, a year? I don't know when Because I have given no timeline, no time to the tarot reading. I don't know when will be the next president and who will become the next president. Is it 3 years? Is it 7 years? I have no idea. So the near future, I don't know. Is it 1 year, 2 years, 3 years? And you have the Devil card, which is Capricorn. It's connected with Capricorn. And this is a clarification card. This is a guy losing his shit. I'm sorry to say this. This is someone losing, going nuts. Okay. So, within the near future, and I don't know when is the near future, I would say during the time Saturn will be transiting Capricorn, during the time Saturn is transiting Capricorn. Saturn, by the way, is called the Devil. It's the old devil. It's a way of reading of. There's many ways of interpreting Saturn. So Saturn could be controlling, could be in a good way controlling and in a bad way controlling. So this is like the bad way. So this is the bad way of trying to dominate people, trying to dominate others, trying to control everything. This could also speak of mental illness because you are obsessing about something. There's several cards that can speak of mental illness. This is one of them, the Devil. The other one is the Moon. Also, the Nine of Swords can speak of mental illness. So, I'm seeing that the current president is losing it, and maybe Saturn in Capricorn is making the transit of Saturn in Capricorn, the sign of Capricorn, is making Trump worse than he is, because he has, it's like making his health, and I'm thinking mental health, worse. He has, Donald Trump has Saturn and Venus in Cancer, and therefore Saturn in Capricorn will be directly opposing his natal Saturn and his natal Venus. Therefore, I would say that the near future might be 1 to 2 years during the transit of Saturn in Capricorn. Something might happen to Donald Trump in terms of his health, and I'm thinking his mental health, that will allow for the plans of this person, of this man, of the next president come into place. Understand? So, or it may be like, or it might even be sooner than he thought. Might be sooner than he thought, because something might happen with the current president. Something might happen with the current president. Something bad, I don't know what it is. I'm thinking, it's something that will make the current president just come and lose it. Just lose his mind, is losing it. It's just behave in a worse way than usual. And because this thing will happen to Donald Trump, that will allow for the next president, or the person who will become the next president, to move in. Do you understand? Feels like a chess game. Biding his time. Doing this in a slowly controlled way, slowly controlled manner. Another way of reading it, these two cards, the near future, it could be that the person who will be the next president of US, again, like I said, might have something in Capricorn or in Earth, and is a very controlling person, but he keeps that thing inside of himself. He hides the fact that he's a very controlling person, and he might have like issues with